Okay, hello guys. It's been a long time for a video from the Fifth Floor Squad. For hockey fans, this is going to be one you're going to want to watch if you're especially a Toronto Maple Leaf fan. I'm going to do one of these things for each of the seven teams. I know I'm a little bit late as the season has already started. I believe the Maple Leafs, at the point of filming this, just beat Montreal last night. It may not be uploaded till a few more games, but right now the Maple Leafs had a good first game coming back against the Montreal Canadiens. They were down 2-1 in the first, I believe, or second. And they came back and won their very first game of the year. James Reimer played a very good game in net for the Maple Leafs in the first game of the season. It's just going to be a little bit of a prediction thing here for me. As you see at the top here, I put the TSM prediction and the Sportsnet predictions here for you guys because I watched both those shows before doing this to see what I would be compared to, what this video would be compared to from actual analysts. I'm not an analyst myself. I watch countless hours of hockey in my spare time. That's usually what I do when I'm not playing video games. So most of the time, I watch hockey whenever there's a hockey game on. So I know a little thing or two about this great sport that is on ice. All right, so just going to go through the forwards, defensemen, and goalies for the Toronto Maple Leafs here for you guys. Carter Ashton, I believe this is his first full year. I believe he's played a few games with the Maple Leafs prior to this season, and this is his first full year. Troy Brody also, I think, is also his first full year. Dave Bolin was required in the offseason, actually, from the championship Chicago Blackhawks. He's going to be, I believe, centering the second or third line, depending on where Clarkson's going to be and Bozak and Kadri. All those other centermen that the Toronto Maple Leafs have. Tyler Bozak, of course, was re-signed the offseason. They also went out and signed big-ticket free agent David Clarkson, who I just previously mentioned. As I'll be mentioning a little later, I think he's going to have a very big year for his first year in his hometown uniform. Jamie Devine, I believe he is like the 13th defenseman kind of guy. He won't be seeing him too much of him as long as there's not a lot of injuries. But right now, I do know Nikolai Kuhlman is injured after, I believe, last night's game. So, anyway, continue on to the third pair, well, not pairing, but you know what I mean, third row of players here, Nazem Kadri. Phil Kessel, of course, apparently he yesterday just signed a huge deal, $8 million per year for 8 years. That's some big money, so he's going to have to perform this season if he wants the fans to believe that he's worth that kind of cash. Nikolai Kuhlman, as I previously mentioned, he, I believe, is injured after last night's game or practiced or something in the previous few days. Joffrey Leupold, a very injury-prone person. Hopefully he can play a full 82 games for the Maple Leafs this season. Jay McClement, he's, I believe, the fourth or fifth string centerman. There's a lot of them on this team. Fraser McLaren, I believe, is also injured. I didn't see him last night in the Montreal-Toronto game, so I don't think he was there. Colt Knorr definitely played last night. If you guys saw that nasty Peros Colt Knorr fight, it was a very to get a little bit off topic here. I don't feel like their hockey fighting should be taken out of the game. It was what I like to call a fluke accident. There really wasn't much anyone could have done about that, in my opinion. So for sake of just like not trying to sound one sided, but I feel like fighting needs to stay in the game. It's a core part of the game. And this happens once in a blue moon, so they should definitely not even question that fighting should be in the game. Mason Raymond, who was signed actually during training camp, he had a good showing at the Maple Leafs. Played very well last night for them in his first game as a Maple Leaf. I think he got a goal, I'm not entirely sure. But so he's been a good pickup for them. And of course, James Van Riemsdyk is the last one. He was picked up a couple years ago from Philadelphia for Luke Shen. He's now in the Philadelphia uniform with his brother. All right, so the defense here is Cody Franzen, Mark Fraser, Jake Gardner, Carl Gunnarsson, Kabordian and Holzer. I actually don't remember that name. I don't think he's actually on the lineup right now. John Michael Lyles, I believe he's actually in the minors now, so I'll have to take him off there as well. Sorry about that. I think he actually was shipped to the minors yesterday or today. I'm not quite sure. Dion Phaneuf is a captain. Paul Ranger coming back after a three-year absence from the NHL. I don't remember what for. And, of course, the rookie, not this past draft, but the draft before that, 2012 draft, first-round pick, Morgan Riley, is now on the team as well. I guess with a few changes, you might be seeing him in and out of the lineup because this team still has a very strong defensive core, even without Lyles. And I guess Holzer's not there as well. Goaltenders, of course, they traded for Jonathan Bernier in the offseason. Him and James Reimer are both very solid goalies. To me, Reimer has more experience, and that's, to me, also why, and also the fact that Reimer got them to Game 7 against Boston last season. Even though that was like one of the biggest throws of a game I've seen in a very long time, I still feel like it wasn't really his fault at all in any way, so I felt like they should definitely have given him the start against Montreal, and they did. I think Bernier is playing tonight against Philly, I believe. They play back-to-back tonight. So to me, I think it's going to be at least the first 10-15 games is going to be a lot of just back and forth until they actually pick which goalie makes more sense for them. All right, so that's pretty much the team there. I'm just going to go through a little bit of predictions for what I see for this team. You know, big years for certain players, the standings, I see them in the playoffs, and maybe a few little more tidbits along the way. My predictions for the goal, four goals against, they're going to be a very strong team this year. They're definitely not going to be Stanley Cup contenders by any means of the imagination, but they're definitely going to be a very good team, fun team, hardworking team. They're going to be great to watch, I think, this whole season. So my prediction is 2.9 goals a game on average, I would say, and 2.41 goals against. So I think the goals against, a lot of people are going to be like, really? Is that too low? Is that too high? I think with the likes of Jonathan Bernier and James Reimer, I think they might give up a little bit more, because a healthy competition might make them play a little more above their heads, you know? So, but that's just kind of like what I'm like around that area. I use a little calculation to kind of predict what I think it will be. So that's what it came out at from the annual calculation. So for me, I think there's going to be big years for two players. Of course, Kadri, as you know, he just signed that, I believe, 1 or 2 year deal, that bridge deal for very low money, just so he could play, right? Because he wants to play, and doesn't want to sit on his ass doing nothing. So he wants to prove that he's worth the $7 or $8 million that he wanted in the offseason. He wanted Tavares' money. I think that's like $6.5-7 million. So I believe he's going to stay true to his form. He's going to have another big season playing with, I guess, the likes of, you know, sometimes it would be Clarkson, Kuhlman, Bolin. It could be any number, because to me, the Toronto Maple Leafs are full of second-line players, even though they have them some of them even down into the third pairing, which to me is not where they belong. But that's, you run out of space when you have a team with so much talent. So to me, I think he's going to have an 80-plus point season. I'm actually leaning more to probably even closer to 95. Maybe, I don't think he'll tip the 100. I think Kessel might be the one that's going to be closest to probably tipping that 100-point mark this season. He's going to have a big fire under his ass trying to make the Leafs fans feel like he's worth $64 million over 8 years. And to me, I think David Clarkson is going to bring those 30-plus goals that he showed in New Jersey last season. And also showed that how he got all that big money in the offseason. I think he's going to have to prove that he's worth it, and I think he will. You know, he is going to miss the first 10 games of the season because, you know, that big fight in the preseason. If you didn't know that happened, I guess you don't watch too much hockey or too much news, but it was a huge fight between the Buffalo Sabres and the Toronto Maple Leafs involving David Clarkson jumping off the bench, which is an automatic 10-game suspension in the preseason. I don't know what it is in the season. I think there is some other rules, so I think that's actually more in the season. But yeah, so I think those three players to me are going to have a little bit of fire under their asses, since, you know, Kadri wants the big money and Clarkson and Kessel kind of just got the big money as of recently. My prediction for the standings is not fourth like TSN, it's not fifth like Sportsnet, it is third in the Atlantic. I think Toronto overall is a better team than the Ottawa Senators, and to me, they're a little bit more deeper, they're more physical, they play that more type of the new Atlantic Division style, where there's a lot of physicalness in the division. Like, you think, like, Boston, Detroit doesn't really fight, they still are a very physical team, of course, coming over from the West with the new divisions, but to me, I feel like they're better than Ottawa, they're better than Montreal, they're better than Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay, I don't even think is really in the contention, to me, for a spot in the postseason. So I'm going to just say that I think they finished third. I think they're going to be right behind Detroit, who's going to finish second. I think Boston will take the Atlantic Division pretty much with ease. And, so they'll finish third for me. And then I think in the playoffs they'll make it past the first round, but I think they'll definitely hit a giant wall in the second round. I think they'll be outed in the second round. So just a little bit of summarization. I feel like the Leafs will have a very strong season this year. They'll score at least half a goal a game more than they'll give up, in my opinion. They'll first finish third in the Atlantic. At least Kadri, Kessel, and Clarkson are going to have fire on their asses, so I'm expecting big seasons from them, and they'll be outed in the second round. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. This is the first of, I believe, there's seven, because there's seven Canadian teams. Sorry, I'm just a little half awake here as I'm making this. But yeah, so the Leafs do play tonight against Philadelphia, then I believe they play Saturday against the Ottawa Senators. So we'll have to see if, I don't know when this is going to be posted, but we'll have to see if, at least by the end of this week, if they can finish 3-0. If they can finish 3-0, well, that's a great start for them. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and have a great night.